Hello Android developers! Welcome to another Android Developer Tips video. In this video, I want to talk about Kotlin inline classes and how they help your API and code to achieve type safety. Before I start, I would like to invite you to subscribe to this channel if you are interested in Android development tips and hit the bell button to get notified whenever there is a new video. Plus, make sure not to miss my monthly interview with Android community active members. You will find a real gem in those talks. Without further ado, let's start. I believe most Kotlin developers have heard or even used inline functions, but maybe not inline classes, also known as value classes. Let's say you are defining APIs for your app's different layers. You may reach a point where you need to be more explicit about data type. Kotlin language offers type aliases, but they are not type safe. They also can be easily overused by their primitive data type, or the unit of the numbers can easily get ignored. For instance, if you define a distance integer alias, it's not clear if the unit is kilometer, meter, or even yard. Therefore, you may need to improve the type name by adding the unit to it, but who knows what can go wrong. You may also think about solutions like defining a data class, but defining an object to keep a primitive value is expensive. Good news is, since Kotlin version 1.5, this requirement is addressed by adding a new aspect called inline class to the language. This is how inline classes are defined. At the moment, which is Kotlin version 1.6, the JVM inline annotation is mandatory. This class is nothing but a wrapper around a value with no overhead. These classes can also contain methods, and it means you may also want to add a validation check at any time. You can think of it as Java int primitive data type versus integer wrapper, including all those boxing and unboxing under the hood at compile time without noticing it. This way, there is no need to define an object, and at the same time, your API achieves type safety, and now you can explicitly define units inside your code. Inline classes can only have a single primitive val parameter in their constructor. They wrap a single primitive variable within, and at compile time, the val class gets replaced with the primitive type under the hood. It also improves your code maintainability at almost no cost. Keep in mind that in contrast with data classes, they do not contain copy, equal, or hash methods. Also, in comparison to type aliases, you cannot assign them instead of their primitive types and vice versa, and this means type safety. Regarding serialization, I can add up that both Kotlin X serialization and JSON support inline classes, and output is a primitive type JSON and not a JSON object. A fact about the definition change of inline class to val class is to not confuse them with inline methods. And also keep in mind that these classes do not get inlined. Let's take a look into the compiled code. You may notice some mangling is happening under the hood. The main reason is to avoid conflict at compile time, first with Java methods and second with your own code methods. You can decide to be in charge of this mangling by adding JVM name annotation. This way you can reach that method from Java code too. In the end, some may argue that inline classes are over-engineering, and selecting a proper variable name or parameter name, or even defining type aliases is enough, but I believe we should use any language features that help with our code readability and maintainability. That's it. I hope you find Kotlin inline classes useful and use them to make your app and APIs more type safe. Please do not forget to like and share this video with other Android and Kotlin developers, and subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. See you soon on another Android Developer Tips video. Bye!